rights organization based in San Francisco. And our presence here in solidarity with African and Palestinian peoples. In fact, we say that Palestinians are the indigenous peoples of Palestine, and we are Palestinians here in this house. The significance of the colonization process that we're talking about. And since 1992, we've also embarked on this campaign that you're all a part of the decolonization, send a message. So we're trying to move things around. And how many people here have heard of the American Indian Movement? Okay, so it's not going to too much aside the history, the occupation of Alcatraz, of course, that occurred here in the Bay Area, 69 to 71, and the American Indian Movement having been created July of 68, and the occupations of buildings that went on since that time, and long walks across the country that have been going on. Of course, Wounded Knee in 73 and 71 days of struggle there would brought a lot of attention. In fact, like Alcatraz, the occupation, Wounded Knee brought a lot of international attention, and the history of the American Indian Movement involvement with networking with Indians all over the world resulted from all these activities that led to the AIM, American Indian Movement, organizing in part in Geneva, Switzerland, the first international Indigenous Peoples Conference. And this was a call for white Indians, if you will, from the Scandinavian regions who are still in their costume and their ceremonies and their songs and their language, and the African continent and peoples from the Pacific and Indigenous peoples throughout the Americas came for the first international conference there in Geneva. And on the wall, as Greg mentioned earlier, that we have over here exhibiting photos on the opposite wall, is a chronology of the movement that led up to the Geneva Conference in 77. And led in part by our elders and the ceremonies that we are very much a part of, which we mean to say we are a spiritual movement also, and foremost, and as a spiritual movement, we sometimes think that we have our own jihad going on here. You know, it's a spiritual struggle, if you will. You know, we've been denied our ceremonies and our spirituality. Many of that went underground until 1978. Many people here may not know, but that is the American Indian Freedom of Religion Act in 1978 that allowed us to provide